Welcome to Defense News Plus. As per news from Reuters, Israeli Air Force attacked on a northwestern Syrian region home to a long-time ruling Assad family, and one civilian was killed and six wounded after an attack on Wednesday. The attack on Latakia province, the ancestral home of President Bashar al-Assad, occurred shortly after 2 a.m., a military source told the Sana news agency. Syrian air defenses intercepted several Israeli missiles during the pre-dawn raids on the Mediterranean port city of Latakia, the Syrian army said on Wednesday. The Israeli attack resulted in one civilian dead and six wounded, including a boy and his mother. According to the source, an attack on Latakia is rare, which is very close to Syria's ally Russia's main airbase of Hamaymim. Western intelligence sources say the strikes conducted to stop the research centers for weapons development, munitions depot, and military convoys moving missiles from Syria to Lebanon. Israel has increased its warning against the bad nuclear deal between Iran and world powers, saying war with Tehran would must be continuing ahead in the coming days. Next update, three Rafale jets took off from France airbase on Wednesday and will reach India tonight. Then total number will be 21, and it will start forming the second squadron of the fighters in the country's eastern sector. An official said that the new jets will be based in Ambala initially before moving to Hasimara when the raising of the squadron begins. All the 36 planes are believed to complete the two squadrons in the IAF's fighter fleet by the end of this year. Now, Indian Navy also wants to buy at least two squadrons of Rafale jets, consist of 36 to 38 in total, for our aircraft carrier INS Vikrant. Indian Navy recommended a special variant which is called Rafale M, means Rafale Marine version. Navy wants to make a deal as early as possible because INS Vikrant is supposed to be officially inducted at the end of this year. Till now, it was decided to have MiG-29 fleet for INS Vikrant, but Indian Navy told that our new aircraft carrier consists of all the modern technology and system, so we should go for such aircraft integrated with high-end technology for INS Vikrant. Indian Navy decided to acquire on lease 36 to 38 Rafale units until our TDBF becomes ready to induct. Now the question is, will France be ready to provide Rafale on lease to India? The answer is, France will definitely provide us the aircrafts as we have a very good relationship with France and also one of the biggest arms supplier to India. India and France will go ahead for price negotiation for the lease of Rafale fighter jet. The officials said that the Indian Navy is aiming to lease Rafale Marine jets for its indigenous aircraft carrier INS Vikrant. This process will help the Indian Navy to train on a platform which will be acquired and minimize the induction process, which usually requires acceptance of necessity, request for information, request for proposal, and clearance from Defense Acquisition Council, Finance Ministry, and Cabinet Committee on Security. In another update from Zona Militar website, a delegation has gone to Argentina. A Chinese delegation has gone to Argentina this week for selling 12 JF-17 fighter jets. The Chinese export company CATIC are supposed to close an agreement for supplying 12 fighter jets to Argentina. Chinese delegation visited the facilities of FADEA, an Argentine aircraft manufacturer, which is said to involve in an assembly line of JF-17 fighter jet. The option for the MiG-35 and JF-17 fighters comes after a British government veto prevents the sale of South Korean planes, which are made with British avionics. The JF-17 uses an engine of Russian origin, the RD-39, a variant developed from RD-33 used by the MiG-35. The Chinese fighter is lighter and less capable of carrying weapons than MiG-35. Despite this, the JF-17 Thunder has sufficient ability to conduct the interceptor fighting mission. It can reach Mach 1.6 and with a combat radius of up to 1,352 km. The fighter has 7 hardpoints that can launch infrared guided air-to-air missiles and air-to-surface and anti-ship weaponry, bombs and cannons. Currently, JF-17 is operated by Pakistan 138 fighter jets, Myanmar 16 in order, and Nigeria, which has recently got 3 fighter jets in 2021. That's it for the day. Please like, share this video and subscribe this channel to get the notification of the next video. Post your valuable comments below. Thank you.